Hi guys, it's Toddy here from Rokombu, and I have the new Nintendo 2DS XL to unbox for you today. Now this console is coming out on July 28th in a whole host of markets, including the UK, but Nintendo sent us one early so we can take a look at the hardware and just see what you're going to get in the box. Now we're not entirely sure whether this is a UK specific or a European model, but we'll find out soon enough. So first and foremost, it's a pretty compact box. Considering it's got an XL console in it, which is kind of nice, really colorful. This is the black and blue. There's also a white and orange option as well. And you can kind of see the product here. I'll get to kind of the feel of it and the look of it once I actually take it out. But yeah, nothing crazy here. It does specify though that, black and turquoise, not blue. It does actually play games all the way back to the original DS. So you have 3DS, new 3DS, regular 3DS, and 2DS game support all in this, which is really nice. Bit of parental information on the side there. Mentioning the fact that it has Amiibo support, a few things that's in the box, which I will come to when we take it out, and compatible with the apps, just kind of reiterating what it's already said. So let's just pull this tab out here. Even got the XL motif all over the packaging. So does this. So there's a few bits in the box as well. So it looks like we have. So you still get the AR cards and the 3DS branded AR cards. So you can still do that by the looks of it, which is cool because that was a fun game. Face Raiders and all that good stuff. Operations manual, specifically, you know, how to charge it, where to put the game cartridges, etc., etc. But that is everything you need to know about that. You can read it for yourself when you get your own. Then we have the console wrapped up in this foam packaging on top, and then I think it's underneath this is a charger. I mean, which is nice because I don't believe, I might be mistaken, but I believe the new 3DS XL and maybe the new 3DS, I'm trying to remember now, didn't come with a power adapter. So it's nice that you do get a power adapter, and this is obviously a European model, so this must be for Germany or other countries that support the 2-pin. But obviously, if you're buying this in the UK, you should get a 3-pin UK adapter. So just know that when you actually come to pick one up yourself, don't worry. And then there's the hardware itself. So here we have the 2DS XL, which looks really nice. They call it the new 2DS XL, but there's no 2DS XL to begin with, as if I'm not massively mistaken. It looks really nice. It's smaller and lighter in kind of every direction and dimension, I should say, over the new 3DS XL. And it looks really nice. I love this kind of two-tone, this accented blue or turquoise, as they call it, pattern. There's a kind of textured plastic there. Sort of reminds me of that woven carbon fiber pattern that you get, you know, with that kind of effect you can see there. It looks nice. It is already picking up fingerprints though, which is something that's worth noting here. And then underneath, it's pretty smooth. We've got the stereo cameras for the AR cards and everything, of course. We've got the power socket. The Z, R, and ZL buttons, as well as the L and R buttons, which they feel nice. The IR blaster there as well. And then on the front side, we have, it looks like we do have stereo speakers, because I believe the regular 2DS just has a mono speaker. So you do actually retain stereo speakers with this one, which is nice. And then you've got the power button here with the charging light and the connectivity light, the wireless light. Volume slider on the left side, which feels pretty good. Regular screws, interestingly, actually, yeah, regular Phillips head screws there. And then under this port here, if I just pull the flap away, which is nice, lots of support there, so that shouldn't break off easily. So you've got both your micro SD card and your game cartridge slot right next to each other, which is pretty good, which is nice as well, because then you can, you don't have to take the back off, which I think you had to do on one of the previous ones, and to get the memory card in at least. So that is all kind of under one slot, very nice and tidy, not exposed or anything like the original 3DS. Here's your stylus, which, does it poke out anymore? That's as much, it just doesn't, it's not telescopic. So the stylus is right next to the headphone jack as well underneath too. But it all feels really nice and neat and tidy, and I love the feel of it in hand in terms of the rounded design. So take this out of the way. So there's no screen protectors by the looks of it. It's straight onto the display, so you can see me there. There you go. Try not to get me in frame. But you have your regular ABXY button, start and select. You have the C stick up here, thumbstick, D-pad, the home button. And then the camera is integrated into the hinge next to the mic, as well as the light here. And then you have this two-stage hinge, which feels very reminiscent of basically all the previous models, so it feels pretty consistent. Pretty thin bezels above and below the main display, which is a 4.88 inch 400 by 240 display. Obviously it's now two-dimensional rather than three-dimensional. That's only really the only real trade-off here in terms of performance or anything like that. You're actually getting the same hardware pretty much as the new 3DS and 3DS XL, so it's a 804 megahertz quad core processor, if I remember correctly, with a 134 megahertz single core and then a 268 megahertz GPU. So it is the same hardware, absolutely the same in that regard. And the screen below is obviously slightly smaller, but it still is XL size. It's a 4.18 inch 320 by 240 screen, so it's a little bit lower resolution, but only really because of the width. So it's the same height and same resolution vertically in that regard. Also, the camera is a 0.3 megapixel camera, I should say. I didn't mention that earlier. And I can't remember the resolution for the stereo cameras on the back, but just know that they're there and they'll work just as they have with every previous iteration. So this looks like a really nice piece of hardware. I mean, there's a little bit of give in the lid there, but again, that is reminiscent of all the previous ones. You can see that. It's not going to be a massive issue, I don't think. I'm hoping viewing angles are good. I'll try powering it on now. Has got a bit of power, but I won't be setting up or anything like that on camera. But as I said at the start of this video, this thing is launching in a number of markets, including the UK, in on July 28th. Oh, wants to touch first. And I'll set the volume down. It's all the same setup process as we've seen before as well, I should say. So this thing is gonna retail, I think you can pre-order it right now and you'll get a, you can see viewing angles there. It's not bad, not great, pretty reflective, but not terrible either. And obviously this is the touch display if you haven't come across a 3DS or a 2DS before. So yeah, this is gonna retail for $129.99. And if you pre-order it right now from Nintendo UK, I believe they also throw in a bag or a carry case, whichever color you go for, which is nice. So that's locked in above the 2DS, which is $79.99 right now. The new 3DS is, the regular 3DS, not the XL, is only £20 more than this, so it's $149.99, and I have seen it for about £10 less as well. So depending on whether you want and need that 3D functionality, which some games it really is nice to have in terms of depth, but it's not essential. This will work with pretty much every game in the 3DS and 2DS and DS back catalog pretty much, so you're covered. My camera's getting drunk. Then, unless you need that 3D functionality, I would say go for this. This feels like a nice, pure, clean take on the 3DS formula, and it takes away one of the few features that I think is, it's a nice to have, but it's definitely not essential. And if you can save yourself some money and still have a premium experience in a smaller, tidier design with those big screens still, then I'd say go for it. The 3DS XL, if you do want it as well, is $179.99. So you are paying a little bit more for that 3D functionality and those larger screens. So that is everything from the Nintendo 2DS XL, or new 2DS XL as they call it. If you have any questions about this console right now, just drop us a line down below in the comments. You can read more on this on recombi.com, and stay tuned for a full review very soon. Thanks for watching.